Hi guys, we're going to be doing an unboxing today, and let's start with the Morphe palette. These are all items that I bought from the US, so let's look at the palettes first. This one is a 35T palette. And from what I remember, yeah, so you've got a few mattes, and then you've got lots and lots of frosty shimmer colours. These are perfect for anyone who loves their golds, pinks, and darker golds like bronze, or I don't even know what colour this is. But they are beautiful and a must have. I think I'd be using this palette a lot. That's the first palette. The second palette I have is the 35L palette. Oh my god. I've been waiting for this palette for over a year now, and it's been out of stock so many times, but I got it finally and it's here now, so I'm quite excited. Oh yeah. So this is the one that you see everywhere sold out. I think they released it in fall autumn one time, as you can tell by the colors, but this would be a go-to palette, like all of them, even that one I'd be using. So yeah, and they are all matte, no shimmers whatsoever. So excited about this one. Then I also got the 35O shimmer, so it's like the other one but in shimmer version as well. They released it earlier this year. And let me see. Ooh. So yeah, none of them are matte in here, they're all shimmers, and I'm pretty sure I'd be happy to use them all. Let me show you side by side with the matte. So they are must haves. If you ever get a chance to get a hold of these, this is always out of stock, but definitely get them. So those are the palettes. I'm going to move on to brushes. So I added two lots of orders. Let's see. Let me just open them all up. I've used their brushes before, I've been using them for like 2-3 years now, and I'm absolutely in love. And that's why you can see I went ahead and I went a bit crazy on brushes. So let's see what we're going to start off with. Start off with face brushes. So I bought a few Durofiber brushes. They're great for powders and liquids, so that's that. I also bought a few goat hair brushes. Some of them are for this one's for contouring, this one's for a face powder. No, I bought this for bronzer actually. I think I saw Jacqueline Hill talk about it one time. But yeah. These are the goat hair ones. I'll be using this one for highlighter. And fluffy brushes, you can never have enough. I also bought some from the Elite collection. This is 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 from the Elite collection. No. These are from the Elite collection, and they're supposed to be the more pro version of things. They seem to be really, really nice in texture, extra fluffy. Can't wait to use this highlighter one. I've got loads of fan brushes, but I heard so much about this one, and I thought, you know, it's small, it's cute. Oh, how'd you open this? So why not? You can't go wrong. Oh, wow. Oh wow, I'm really liking this. This is the 6M. Oh, it's not from the Elite collection. This one's the M 601. That's that. I bought this one for contouring the nose. This is the E47. If you want me to do a brush, favourite brush tutorial, whatever, I'll be doing that. These are a few other face brushes. Some eye brushes, some fluffy brushes. I wanted to show you these ones. Concealer brush, eye pencil, another eye pencil. Anyway, I am so in love with this one. I've actually got two of them already. This is the M507 and it is super, super amazing. You can use it for the crease, you can use it underneath the eye, you can use it for nose contour, you can use it for highlighting. There's so many things you can use this for. It's super soft and they last forever. I've had my other two, I've had them for a year and a half now. So I decided to buy some more. That's another one, so I decided to buy three. And this one, this from the Elite Collection actually, I forgot to mention. But this is a detail under eye smudger brush and it is the E36. So that's my brushes. I'm going to put them to one side. And these are the concealers. They launched, I think, in the summer, in April. So this one is Macchiato. I wanted to see how they are. I heard so much about them, so I wanted to see how they are. That's that. This one's Macchiato too. Oh. And this one is in Honey. So you can see the difference between the two. So that one is Macchiato and that one's Honey. So that's the concealers. And we also bought a number of single shadows, so lots of different colours. But what I wanted to show you are these bad boys. So these are the pressed pigments. I'm going to show you, oh, which one should I show you? I'll show you this one. This one is Untamed. Look at that. Look at that. How amazing is that? Anyway, these are all the pigments. So this is something I got from Sephora last year in pink, so now I thought I'd order it in black. Makeup Erase. I actually use this when I have heavy duty makeup on and I can't be bothered. So it might be a wedding, it might be Eid, it might be whatever the major occasion is. I'll be using this and then I'll do my normal routine on top. I also got LA lip paint. It's just something I wanted to try. I saw it on the website, why not? And I also got the Jeffree Star liquid lips in Leo and Androgyny, I think that's how you spell them. Let me show you the colours. I've already tried this one and it's amazing. So these are the two colours. They are right there. So next we're going to be going through the BH Cosmetics range. Let me show you the Carly Bible palette first. I've got four of them this time because I go through these a lot. I've opened my third one just at the end of this year. I'll show you what it looks like. It looks like this. It is super, super affordable, super blendable, and it is so easy to use. I also recommend people who are new to makeup, or beginners, anything like that, you'll be able to do eyeshadow with this. Anyway, these are eyeshadows and these are highlighters. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 matte, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shimmers, and they range from like a pale pink all the way to a bronze colour. So that's the palette. So yeah, I got 5 for this year. So I don't know what this is. Well, it's a contour palette, but I actually can't remember if it's cream or powder, because when I purchased it, I think I was half asleep. I'm really bad at unboxing. It's powder. So you've got your highlighter, these two would be your corrector tones, and then you got your bronze. I probably use that for nose contouring, that for bronzing, these two more for the grey sculpting effect. So I can't remember how much this one is, but it's probably affordable, that's why I just chucked it in without even checking if it's cream or powder. I bought a brow pencil, I just wanted to test these out. I cannot remember what they look like. Okay, right, the mini pencils. Standard pencils, I guess. I'll be blogging about these, so these will be my personal, in my personal kit. I also got liquid lipstick. I wanted to try how they were, because they were super affordable. And I remember someone talking about it on their social media. So this colour is Lust. It's a deep red, maroon red. Ooh, that looks nice. But yeah, I'll see how that looks on the lips. Always test liquid lips on the lips. They look great on the hand, but when you put it on your lips, it's a different story. Eyeliners, blusher, brush set. I've got this one before. Actually bought it from my cousin. Hopefully I'm gonna put it the right way. Yeah, their brushes are so fluffy. I've used this one before and they are amazing and they're so affordable. If you live in America and you don't know what BH Cosmetic is, you're missing out. And if you live anywhere else, do whatever you can to get hands on them. And I also bought brush cleaner. Makeup brush cleaner? Yeah, brush cleaner. I go through loads of them all the time, so I thought I'd try a new one. And if it's rubbish, then I think it was only about £7-8. But I hope it does good. Next, we're going to be moving on to the Anastasia. So these are contour refills. One second, let me go show you my palette. So let me show you, this is where I keep my contour palette. I've taken out the original case and I've put it in the magnetic one. This is not a Z palette, but you can use Z palettes. This is bigger than a Z palette. There are 6 of, that's the light to medium contour kit, I believe, and this is the glow kit. So I've bought some more refills of the contour shades. This one's actually corrector shade, Golden Peach, and the rest of them are contour shades, really. So that I'll be adding into there. I also got another Brow Wiz. Let me just show it to you. This one's in dark brown. It's actually quite similar to the BH Cosmetic one, which is in medium. Interesting. I'll do a review for them in a comparison on the blog. Then I got What is this? Two lip glosses. Yeah, two lip glosses from Anastasia. This is Metallic Rose. And this one is Kirsten. So this one's more the full gloss finish, and this one, it's got spicks of glitter in it, as you can see. Let me swatch that for you. That's dried up pretty well. It's transferred a bit, but oh, I can see that going well on my bridal kit. And then this one, pretty. See that going well with any party or bridal Mendy look that I think would go really nicely with. Then I've got two concealers. I've already got the 1.5. I've been using it all year actually. This one's 0.7 and this one is 3.5. So a lot of difference. This one's more pale and this one's more orangey toned. Anyway, I love the way they package this, because people like me who don't know how to unbox just flip it up. So easy. Why can't they make all packages like this? These are super thick and creamy, by the way, so you'd only need a little bit of it. See, another great package. This is the one of the cream liners in honey. It's like a nudie colour. I think it goes really nicely with, for the bridal look, especially when they want it in the waterline. I also got gel liner, and then I got these. This is the foundation, no, this is the contour stick, and this is the foundation stick. So I got, and I got another one. This one's the golden one, and this is the contour stick in mink. A really grey sort of brown, and if you stalk like I'm Razy like I do, this is what she actually uses to contour. I did get another foundation, but I don't know where it is right now. I think I opened it and used it because I couldn't wait. This one is golden, pretty similar to my skin tone. And that's the foundation. I've heard so many good things about this. I'm not a cream foundation lover, well, on myself anyway. So let's see how it goes. And this is Illuminator. I actually have been waiting a while for this one. It is, yes, the So Hollywood Illuminator. It's been out of stock for so long, I think for about a year or so. But it's so beautiful. A lot of people have asked me to get this for them, and unfortunately can't get it for everyone. There's a limit of 4, by the way, per purchase. Anyway, I'll swatch that for you. We'd find space. Yes, yes, yes. I think it will be a favourite, but it's quite... Well, it is an illuminator, so it'll be quite bold compared to her glow kit. So I'll show you, it's quite similar to this one. But the gleam and the glow kits are quite, what do you want to call it? So yeah, her gleam and glow kits are quite, they're nice, but they're not as illuminated, but which is fine. Can't always be shining around. So the last one we have here is the Colourpop package. I did open it, but anyway, I thought I'd unbox it with you. Damn. Yeah, I went a bit crazy. So, hi love, you have perfect taste from Colourpop. Oh, thank you. Oh, what's this? So they sent, basically they were a bit late on delivery, so they sent, sorry, we're late. And three, what is it? Ultra Glossy Lip Gloss. So wait, let me just see what this looks like. Ooh. Oh, okay. It's not too far from Kirsten from Anastasia. It's quite similar in texture, but Anastasia's got a bit more of a stick to it. So let's start off with the lips then, shall we? So, as we're on the gloss, Ultra Glossy Lip. So that is in Finders Keepers. This one is Wayo. It's like a nudie shade. If you want a separate video on swatches, I'll do that. Oh, wow. You know what? I actually forgot I would do Suki. I need to swatch this. Ooh. And the applicator is actually quite similar to Jeffree Star. It's quite soft. It's not very sturdy like the other ones. I bought two sets and the rest I bought individual. So this one has, oh no, there's another Suki over here. So I bought two. Okay, that's fine. As you can see, all the satin lip, all in a neon yellow colour. The lip glosses are in a pink, bright hot pink colour. So we'll start with satin. Quite similar to, I think I bought similar colours. Just want to see. Yeah, similar to that one, isn't it? So this one is Calypso. Let's see what other colours I've got. Another pink. Ooh. This is Lion King, I know it is. Yeah, it's a super, super shocking pink. Not for your everyday wear. It's a beautiful pink though. This is Echo Park. This is a nude one, or a peachy one, I think. Yeah. Oh my god, I've got similar colours again. And then this is Hutch. This is Satin. It's like a purple plum. Then these are all matte. So that's like a terracotta colour. This is Speed Dial, peach colour. Another peach colour. Oh, I already got Bumble. Another one, anyway. This one is Mama. Ooh. You know, I actually forgot I ordered some of these colours. Interesting, interesting. I'm gonna have to use this sometime soon and see how it actually looks. If not, I'll just be using it for my looks or something like that. Notion. I think this is a deep, yeah, berry colour. Then you've got, where is it gone? Oh, this is the green. You'll probably think I'm a bit crazy for ordering this, but my friend tried to stop me and I was like, no, I really want to do it. So you'll probably see this in one of my looks soon, because I doubt any clients are going to be asking for this colour. Yes. Didn't realise I ordered so many. What's this? LAX. Yes. Similar to that. It's quite similar in shade. Bit similar to the Wicked colour from Lime Crime. Then I've got Creeper. This is supposed to be a really bright red, I remember from the name. So let's see how bright it actually is. It's a bit orange. It's orange red. Okay, didn't expect that. That's why you shouldn't be ordering too many things online. Rimeo 2, it's like a mauvey taupe colour, I think. It's quite similar to that. I'm just going to swatch it near here because I want to see how silly I am for ordering very similar colours. And then these are the cream gel liners that I have ordered. I'm not going to open these. That's that. What's this? Oh, I ordered a lippy stick. But this is supposed to be really nice. I'll actually order this for my mum because she is in love with this colour. Just a really soft pink. Okay, they don't have names on it. I'll make sure they have names on it. Swift. I was really looking forward to ordering this colour because I think they all just look so nice on the skin. They're kind of like creamy. That's blushes. Then all of these are eyeshadows. This one is a highlighter. This one's not for me, this one's for someone else. But I want to show you this colour because this one's a duochrome. I remember when I ordered it. I think I'm going to have to do a swatch video. Which finger of mine is clean? So that's what it is. And it's a duochrome colour. So it's like a brown glitzy of purple and teal in there. So yeah. I probably shouldn't have ordered this many. I can't even hold the rest in my hand right now. But I probably shouldn't have ordered this much. Thank you for watching. These are all the swatches on my hand, by the way. But I think I will have to do a ColourPop swatch video. But if you want me to see, if you want to see other swatches or other products, let me know. Now I'm gonna go clear all this up. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.